Next, I'm going to show you how to use the Insight Generator tool. So this tool is pretty cool. It's used to basically extract auto-suggest keywords from four different sources in a very specific way. If you put the word puppy training like this, it's going to put special words afterwards and before in order to generate insights, like really insightful type of keywords. And so I'd like to explain how this works by looking at a tool online where I got this idea from. In fact, a lot of customers asked me to build this, so I decided to put it inside of that software. But if you go to Answer the Public, it's a product by Neil Patel, and a lot of people use this, and you can see they got the four different sources here. But if I say, if I select US, if I can find it here, I thought it was at the top, there it is, and type in puppy training, you're allowed to do a maximum of 3 searches per day for free. Then they have, they got a new thing there. Okay, we'll let this work. And they provide it in this kind of circular thing, which I don't even like, but I like the list part. And so basically here you get all these different words. So they're based on different modifiers. So let me show you what they are. If you go back to the wheels, these are the questions, and modifiers are added to that seed keyword to create questions. Then there's prepositions, comparison, and alphabetical. So I've basically done the same thing in the Insight Analyzer software, but obviously the big advantage is you can do it unlimited searches. There's absolutely no monthly payments, no credit to pay, or nothing like that. So that's the big advantage. Otherwise, you got to come over here and play monthly. So if I do that here, and I'll do Google Source, and you can see here that you can select the search type. So there's questions, the prepositions, the comparisons, and alphabetical. So what does that mean? To really see what that means, why don't we just click this button to look at the modifiers in the modifier edit window. So in this window here, you can actually see the modifiers, and you can edit them if you want. So what's happening? You see my seed keyword is puppy training. What's going to happen is this software is going to stick the word are, can, how, what, when, and all this before the main keyword, where this asterisk is basically representing the keyword here. So to understand that fully, I want to take you to Google, and let's type in puppy training. And you could see the puppy training there, and these are the auto suggests. But if I at the beginning, if I put R, you get all these extra, like there's basically questions, like these are kind of question modifiers. So it's forcing Google to come up with the next possible searched questions. And these are what are being extracted. And then the prepositions are just adding words after. And then there's the comparisons. And then the alphabetical is just appending the alphabet to get extra keywords in the auto suggest, like that sort of thing. So if you go ahead, and like I said, you can change them. Like for example, down here, you could put like did, like that. So let's do that, click OK. So now if we, let's just do one at a time to take a look. Let's just do questions. And of course you can select the source, the country, in the language. The country and language will change depending on what you select. You don't have all of them in the same. That's actually really difficult to program, but I eventually figured it out. So if you go generate, you can see how fast this is. And now you can see I spelled puppy training wrong. That's why there wasn't many. Let's try that again. Training. There. Now I'll do it again. There we go, that's better. Now we got 85 different questions, and now this is kind of like giving you more insights into what people are actually thinking when they're typing in keywords into Google. So it's kind of like the people also ask, but what's awesome is since we've got both tools in one software, so it's kind of like when you're out buying tools online to do things, this is like having two tools that you have to pay for monthly in one, and you don't have to pay anything monthly. So it's pretty awesome. Anyhow, because you can take some of these things like our puppy training pad scented, our puppy training pad's good. You can take this, send it over the PA questions and start extracting the questions around that and get more ideas for content. So I just did two levels so you can see what people are asking. So it's pretty powerful. So let's clear that out. Let's try taking a look at the prepositions. So, gives you a whole bunch of more ideas. And then the comparisons, puppy training and boarding. Puppy training should, pretty cool. Nothing was for versus there, so. And then, of course, alphabetical. You get tons of more keywords that you can go and explore. These are not quite long tail, but you can, if you want to look for more long tail keywords, you can just filter the word count, say more than four, and get some really long tail keywords that you can work with. So if you select all of them, let's see how many we get for puppy training. It's very fast. So we got, you know, 454. And we switch over to Bing, do the same thing. Then YouTube. So you see how quickly you can generate over 1,000 keywords. Amazon. Amazon can take just a little bit longer to get the data. So we got 1,448 keywords that we can start analyzing. And just like with the PAA extractor tool and other videos I've shown, you can also get search volume data inside the software here. I'll show you the ways to do it. So if you go to search volume, you could import it from free sources, which is the Google Keyword Planner and the searchvolume.io. So you can use this tool. I have another video showing how to use it, so go ahead and watch that. Or you can just use this copy button. You could select all keywords and it will take you directly to the Google Keyword Planner, where you can just click search here and search volume and forecast, and then just right click and paste. It automatically copied all into the clipboard. Click get started. And I got all these for Canada. Here you could change the location and language. But when you download this, takes a second here. All right, let's download it to a different folder where I've been working here. Let's go here. You can always get to the folder by using Chrome, because the little thing here, but I actually have the Explorer open, and then all you have to do is just drag it in. I grabbed the wrong file by accident there. Let's grab this one. And there we go. And now we have the search volume in here. And now we can see which ones are getting a lot of search volume and cost per click and competition. So competition is from 0 to 100. So the higher this number, the more competitive that keyword is. This is how much cost per click that advertisers will spend on one click to get this, to pay for this particular keyword. So puppy training online. Now, as we can see here, we do have a ton of repeat words. That's because these words were being generated from multiple sources. So puppy training online probably came from Bing and Amazon, or Bing and YouTube, and maybe even Amazon. Again, that's why we see three of them. So maybe Bing, Google, Bing and YouTube. But we can quickly get rid of those. You can just right click and go delete and remove duplicates. It found 410 duplicates, and so now we're back to 1,038. So now we have our keywords here. And you can see here there's also a column, a seed column. It's showing you where this actually came from. So that was the full word that was put into Google or whatever source it was in. And then this was the modifier that was used associated with it. So now we can utilize this data. So you can utilize this data and write content around stuff that has higher search volumes, or I would suggest maybe taking these over to the PA extractor as I've shown you and start you know, getting more content ideas. But having the combination of these two tools in one software is going to save you like probably over $1,000 a year just paying all those other tools. So, and of course, you can add any modifier you really want. So if you come here back to the modifiers, even though this is question modifiers, you could just add anything really you want in here that can be before the seed keyword or after. So these are just sort of like, I know it says question modifiers, preposition, comparison, but realistically you can write anything in here you want and you can save it. And if you always want to get back to the defaults, just click this defaults and it will go back to defaults. And you can also save your modifiers to a text file and load them back in, copy and paste here for each of them. Just remember that when you do put some other words in here, you always have to include that asterisk, because that asterisk, that represents the actual seed keyword that's going to be put in there. So if you don't have an asterisk in there, you try to save it, you can get a little warning. So make sure you include that in there. So pretty easy, but I like the one did now. Keep that in there. Click OK. So now you can write your content around the keywords that you want in here. And if you want to deliver it to your content creators or save it for later, what you want to do is go to File, and you can save it to comma delimited file, text file, or you just save only the keywords to a CSV or text. So plus you can save it to a project file. Obviously that's, you want to be doing that quite a bit. So let's go ahead and just save it as comma delimited. And we'll just call it, I don't know, puppy training. Save that. And if we open that up, take a look. So you got all the data in here, plus if the monthly searches and what competition and the CPCs provided, it'll also be in here. So that's really handy. And if you want to create content within the software, then you can use the AI features. I'll be providing other videos on it, but basically you can find a keyword you like to, for example, puppy training, hand signals, if you right click, you can send that over to the AI built-in generator, or you can send it over to the AI browser, and I'll have other videos showing how to do that. So that's it for this video. That's how you use the Insight Generator to get a lot more keywords that are really, Google's really telling you, these are what people are also searching for. They're trying to guess your next insight into your search phrase. So these are very powerful keywords.